driving it here to the 10-yard line. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. The gun, they run it with Hunt. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow.
Charles, what a big drive late in the fourth quarter to take this lead.
And normally you're really excited if your offense has the ball late in the game. I think this crew is really excited to have their defense go back out there because they haven't surrendered a point in the fourth quarter yet. They've helped make this comeback possible with their defensive play. Now they get a chance to finish this game off.
And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now.
Hey, cut, cut. Wait, wait, wait.
Garoppolo to throw. Pass complete, Samuel. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game.
Here we go.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. To throw is Garoppolo. That is incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Back to throw, Garoppolo. And this one is incomplete.
I think we're both wondering if we were going to see them try and push it deep downfield, facing a one-possession deficit late, and they certainly didn't disappoint. They gave it an effort.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now Garoppolo. And he's got McCaffrey open, complete. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout. As the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
To throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Jadeveon Clowney, give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. What a thrilling fourth quarter this one was. Well, at least I guess if you're cheering for the winning side, an outstanding comeback though that saw them completely take control and change the outcome of this game.
Yeah, I'm not sure how many of us saw that coming, the way that they were playing and having the lead after three quarters. A little bit of a stunning ending because it wasn't just a one touchdown swing, it was a multiple touchdown swing for them to end up losing that ball game. Give credit where credit is due. They came off the pace and got it done. We'll be right back.
sound like some superheroes. Some black superheroes. Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero. Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero.
You need a hero like me. Military mind stated, and I keep a in a degree. You can label me a Huey P. Made a martyr out of Martin, out of Malcolm, out of Mega. I refuse to let these dirty devils make Michael a beggar. A hero, CEO, I will go Magneto for my people. Give me liberty or death, that is my credo, not my ego. Dressed in a tuxedo, entered party, alter ego. Killed your leader in gazebo, did it for the people. Love what motivated, I did not do it for hatred. But I truly hate the devil, I cannot debate or fake it. I was asked a question and the asker thought it hard. If I was facing death and I could ask one thing of God, I would ask for every to be free here and abroad. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God.
Need a black superhero. Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero. Our own kind took myth from us. Money still we in God we trust. Truthfully we envy, so why we so envious? And why our own kind envy us? Our shit is hard, but we gotta keep our head up. Even though we know we fed up, it's hell attention. Cause we ain't careful where we all pay attention. I need all my real soldiers on the front line, fighting for the right just one time. So unstoppable together at the same time, with the same mind. Yeah, we're gonna be high and always above what's beneath us. So
every block, every hood.
I'm talking bulletproof, kind of suit, reflect the struggle that they put us through, with the strength to fight the power like Chuck D a dude, with the insight to be equal, no disguise needed, a voice that finds reason to multiply people in the streets for the cause, marching on Washington might as well be walking through walls, type of superhero show up when ain't no one to call, that'll shield you from them shields that been killing us all, high beams for eyes to peek, the villains in the dark, power of resolution for a war would even start, the knowledge to build and grow where they live and take care of the kids and the older folk, the queen cause they need it most, politic with the kings, about economic growth, cure PTSD, cause mental health ain't a joke, feed the hungry and dope, everyone would know, everywhere we go,
every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto, need a black superhero. Superheroes. It's gonna take one of us to save us. It's gonna take love and a lot of trust. We just got to keep the faith and know that. Well, guess you got mine, I got your back, I know. It's gonna take one of us to save us. It's gonna take love and a lot of trust. We just got to keep the faith and know that. Well, guess you got mine, I got your back, I know.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Black superhero.
Said I'm coming for everything. You good? up, but to be great, you gotta have confidence. The next level is legend. You gotta have accomplishments. In any league, they considering me dominant. The long falls, you know, the pit of the feet, bottomless. I was hungry way before I got your support. I hopped off the porch around the time that y'all got awards. Lyrical exercise, this is what I call a sport. The fourth bar, brother, but I push the rock off the court. I got champion genetics. Champion genetics. Next level. One of the best. Remember me. I am the great. You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me. Remember me. I am the great. Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything. I am the great. You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me. Remember me. I am the great. Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything. The cat and mouse, whose talent don't average out. If your flow ain't nowhere near this caliber, that don't count. Competition get flattened out. Getting money like I went top three in the first round. My salary that amount. They want my style, but that ain't much to be flat about. I take it as a challenge when rappers calling my status out. One of the best, and they ain't my pedigree. You can have the rings, or we did an AI's legacy. I got champion genetics. Champion genetics. Next level. One of the best. Remember me. I am the first. You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me. I said I am the first. Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything. I am the first. You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me.
This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the New York Jets. Greg Zuerlein set to get us started here, and off we go from MetLife Stadium. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. ETN to start the drive. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Go again with ETN, and he'll push ahead for about three to the 36.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Lawrence on third down. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. On the counter, ETN. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Okay. On second down, ETN once more.
He'll wind up getting four down to the 36.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this. Yard line.
He was brought down at the 26. A gain of 11 on the play. And the Jaguars first down.
On first and 10, it's ETN.
And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. 2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
But they're certainly not neglecting their run duties as well as they ate up the blockers in front, allowed the secondary to get home.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12.
ETN once more.
And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line.
He lost four there, and it's third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now Lawrence on third and long.
And able to find Kirk complete. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And they'll run with ETN.
And he'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown.
Travis ETN.
Taking it in from 2 yards out.
And the Jaguars will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Extra point by Patterson, up and good.
And that makes the score 7-0.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Reed going to bring it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Wilson leading the Jets up now for a first and 10.
At their own 18.
They'll start on the ground, Hall.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. They go play action now. Wilson. Steps away to his left. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 32 that time. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
Yeah.
action. It's Wilson. Open man here is Conklin. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hall. Touchdown, Jets! Brees Hall, 34 yards. And the Jets are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
As the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively.
Hey, go! Hey, exit!
Looking to throw on second down. Lawrence. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, the best don't mind making tough throws, but that was a real difficult one right there. Out of the pocket, trying to beat double coverage. More times than not, that's going to end up as an incomplete pass, if not worse.
On third down, Lawrence. And Ingram hauls it in. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 27 yards there on a very nice third down conversion. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. ETN up the middle. Room here to run. The 20. 5. Touchdown, Jaguars. Travis Etienne with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Jaguars have taken the lead. Extra point by Patterson up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback. The New York offense taking over for their next possession.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
This one caught by Davis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Wilson. And that one incomplete, but now a penalty flag coming in late. That might be P.I.
So a costly penalty yardage-wise, as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing is Wilson.
He dumps this one off here to Hall.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
We saw him shed a nice tackle on that play.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
To throw again on second down, Wilson. Touchdown! Denzel Mims from 21 yards away. And the Jets are an extra point away from evening this one up. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. But right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
On second down, a run with ETN. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Yeah, yeah. Hey, now Lawrence to throw. That's complete to Travis Etienne out of the backfield. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 35.
Running their plays over and over during the week can often get robotic for an offense, but on game day, they can often flow smoothly, as that one just did.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Straight ahead, Etienne. Oh, fine work there as he gets this thing down to the 11-yard line. 87 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in his first half. On first down, right back to Etienne. And he'll take this one inside the 10 down to the 8.
The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Another tote for ETN. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Travis ETN on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Jaguars have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now it's Wilson. He'll air this one out for Mims. And that is incomplete.
He's put up numbers in this one by pushing the envelope a bit whenever he could with deeper throws. But let's play a little philosophy here. Some plays it works, sometimes they're ready for you. And that time, they were on guard. Incomplete.
He'll air this one out for Mims. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Jets going to get the football first, and they trail as well as we get back underway in this second half. Reed going to bring it out of the end zone. And they'll be backed up to start this drive as he's taken down right around the 15. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. But Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer. Here we go.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Wilson. And that's going to be caught downfield by Mims. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 75 yards receiving for him now. It's a first down. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. On first and 10, it's Hall. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Here's Wilson to throw. That is caught by Mims. Past the 20. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find them at the wide receiver position, and that was special there. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
To throw on second and 10, Wilson. That's to Davis, he's got it. Touchdown, New York. Corey Davis, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Jets are an extra point away from drawing level. Zerline connects on the extra point, and we are tied at 21. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he's only going to get this to the 4-yard line.
Well, not exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way now to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
They'll start on the ground, ETN. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. 116 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. Now they can breathe a little easier, some room to operate, as they've got a first and 10 now out past the 20. A handoff for ETN. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. This is caught. It's Kirk. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Here's a give to ETN. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Here's Lawrence. Looking downfield for Jones. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Sauce Gardner picks it off. And the Jets are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratch. He's got a man complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 26 yards. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Wilson. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
And the Jags with 5 in the secondary now on third down. They'll run with Hall. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've run the ball 3 times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
Now Wilson on first down. He finds his man complete. It's Wilson. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And it'll be second down. And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Play action. Now Wilson. Open man is Uzama. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. A field goal could get them the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. They'll run with Hall. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. Second and goal from the six this time. Now they'll get this to Mims on the jet sweep. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Denzel Mims. His second touchdown of the night. And the Jets have broken our tie and have taken a fourth quarter lead. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And they will take a 7-point lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. The pressure is on now. They're being shut out here in the second half after a decent first half offensively. They need their best drive of the game right here. Up to the 20.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he's taken down, back at his own 7. So now after the sack of Lawrence, the Jags looking at a 3rd and long. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Jet touchdown. Little bit of a backbreaker right there. You're down close, 1-score game, trying to push the ball down the field and score, and you throw a pick six.
And sometimes you take a little bit of a gamble when you're making your throws, right? Sometimes you press it a little bit more than maybe you wanted to because you want that score so badly. In this case, it cost them.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A 2-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. Oh, that's the 3rd interception for Lawrence. Picked up by DJ Reed. If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
Yeah, to put it mildly, look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all, and you're exactly right.
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 45 yards. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is 1st and goal. Now Wilson. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. They'll try to run with Hall. And a nice job to break free of 1 tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. On 3rd and goal, Wilson. Touchdown, Jets. Tyler Conklin. Excellent work there to get in on the touchdown run. And the Jets have put this one to bed here in the 4th quarter. Zuerlein connects on the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. and the touchdown at Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 of the 24. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. This game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
On second and nine, Lawrence. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Sauce Gardner picks it off, and the Jets are going to take possession of the football.
Well, let's face it, Brandon, they're down here in the second half. Want to try and make something happen, and if you're the guy with the ball in your hands, you're going to try even harder, because I think all he was trying to do was to get outside the pocket and see if he can find a big play downfield.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, fourth quarter with a three-score lead here, Charles, but they're still going back to the air and looking for more points.
Well, with this game well in hand, it's an opportunity for the guys to come off the bench and get a chance to play.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And the Jags grab it. The 40. The 30. 20. 10. And it's a defensive return for a late touchdown. So they still need somewhat of a miracle here, but at least that gets them a little bit closer.
Patterson now for the extra point.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. Oh, no, it's intercepted. And a short return to the 6-yard line. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return.
Fielded just outside the goal line.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. Oh, Wilson gonna throw. Sliding out of the pocket. He's got a man, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. They go play action with Wilson. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell. And the Jaguars force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. From the 35 on second down, Lawrence. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is caught inside the five. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. Looking to throw, Lawrence. Flush to his right. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, so they got the score. Do you go for one here and save the possible two-point conversion for later?
I think you do, because if you go for two here and you don't get it, that's deflation.
Yeah.
Now you wonder why you're even going for it. Take the easy one now and come back and try and get it later.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And he'll conserve whatever time he can as they'll opt to bring it out to the 25-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Wilson wants to throw it. He'll air this one out deep for Davis. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Wilson to throw. He's going to try and go deep again. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Andre Sisco. And the Jags come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. Like all great games, it came down to the final snap, Charles. They had to heave it and hope, but the Hail Mary ultimately intercepted, and that's your ball game.
Yeah, and you never want to be in a situation where your entire game comes down to throwing a jump ball as far as you can. But in that situation, you want to loft it up and hope one of your guys can win in the air. This time, though, this is the defender who got up there, and that was the end of the ball game. Close them throughout, one team just had a little bit more at the end than the other.